So, the reason I want to talk about lip trills today, or lip rolls as they're sometimes called, is not because they're the most significant or important of exercises, but because there are so many people that seem to teach this exercise, and a lot of online examples of demonstrations and on videos, and they are, in my view, inaccurate and misleading, and in fact, damaging for the voice if you don't do the lip roll the right way. So I'm hoping to clear up some misunderstandings with this particular teaching clip. So just to review quickly, what we need to do is to make sure that any exercise that we're doing for the voice must accomplish at least one of three things. It must help improve the efficiency and ease of the breath flow. Secondly, the vibratory mechanism must be looked after. And third, the resonance system must actually be working at its optimal efficiency. So what we need to look at is whether the way that people are doing lip rolls is actually helping those three things or in some way getting in the way of those three things. Now notice that that sound is quite clear, it's quite well projected, it's got a very clear attack at the start of the sound. That is better breath flow, it's looser muscles around the resonance system, the jaw and the lips, and it's much more relaxed in the throat and therefore on the vibratory mechanism of the larynx and its parts. Basically, the way most people are doing their warm-ups is with a very gripped jaw, gripped lips, i.e. close up the resonance, in fact. Also, they're doing it in a way that tightens the back and root of the tongue and also the neck muscles. And you might have seen this area kind of jump as I started, and you'll see that closer up in a minute on the next bit of video. And also the airflow is being started with a kind of a... Basically, the vocal cords are shut at the start and I'm almost kicking them, booting them open to start the sound. Like that, rather than that looser start with the vocal cords draw together gently as the airflow begins. Or and what you hopefully can hear is that the sound is much more resonant and fuller and deeper, in a sense, when I do this looser start with the airflow and the lips and the jaw more relaxed. Now, I think it's worth taking a moment to consider why would it matter whether we do this lip trill exactly right or not. After all, we're getting the breath going, we're getting the voice going, so we're sort of warming up. Well, the answer is I think it matters a great deal, because everything that we get our muscles to do over a number of occasions, the muscles learn. I.e. the brain learns that muscular pattern. And we are basically laying down and automating and conditioning a pathway where every time we start our voices up, we squeeze and jam our breath, we tighten our muscles and the tongue root and close up the jaw and lips. So if you keep repeating that because you're supposedly warming up with this lip roll the wrong way, then that's what the muscles will remember. So that when you start singing, you will start doing the same thing. You will have this more cramped breath flow. You'll have the tighter neck and throat muscles, and the resonance system will be closed down. What happens is if you convert the tight lip roll into singing, this is what happens. That's repeating the tight version of my lip roll in a version of singing. And that singing using the muscles in the way that repeats and replicates what I was doing with the properly practiced lip roll. And I'll show you in a slightly later video teaching session how to get the breath flow working and the lips enough relaxed in order to get that lip roll working properly.